McQuill's Media and Mass Communication Theory is an epic book. It's a book about books. It's a story of who we are as students and scholars of media and mass communication. It's about what we do, how we do it, and perhaps most importantly, why we study the media and mass communication, why we consider it so important, the role and the influence and the effects that media have on public opinion and on people's everyday lives. The new edition of McQuill's handbook is first and foremost an homage to his incredible legacy that he left us until his passing a couple of years ago. Working with Dennis has been a tremendous privilege, and it's been a lot of fun, especially thinking about how we try to adapt the book to the 21st century, to a new generation of students and scholars engaging with these materials. The changes we've made compared to previous editions are first and foremost a true integration of humanities and social science-based perspectives, approaches, and methods to the study of media and mass communication. We've added the word media to the title to articulate the role, the significant role that media theory plays in the field today, and to join communication science and media studies approaches. Secondly, we've addressed the realities of what it's like to make media professionally in the world today, in part because so many of the students in our courses, in media and communication types courses, are there because they want a career in these media, but also a true critical and an empirical understanding of the role that media play in everyday life comes from an appreciation of how media actually get made. A third intervention we made is to work hard to diversify the range of voices and sources in the book. In part, this has to do with making the book more a reflection of the truly global nature of our field, an acknowledgement that the industries that we're talking about are truly global industries, but also to include voices from literatures that are open access. And finally, we've tried to take the discussion on the influence and effects of media to a new level. Rather than simply discussing the various theories and methods that we've used in the past as a field to study and interrogate the effects and influence of media, we've now looked at media effects as a canon, as a range of concerns that people have throughout history over and over again about the role that media play when it comes to children, to the young, to politics and our political system, to social cohesion and polarization. These are recurring concerns that we've now framed historically and pulled into the 21st century. Put all of this together, I'm really excited and incredibly privileged to have been working on this new edition, and I hope you'll find it useful too.